I'm going to bring you more details on what is a huge stash of paintings that's been uncovered in Germany. We were telling you this story last night at this time, but we had no idea just what this entailed. It's thought to be worth $1 billion. Take a look. This one here, a painting by the celebrated artist Mark Chagall. It's believed to date back to the 1920s, and it's one of many previously unregistered works. And this is what's interesting about this story. German artist Otto Dix painted these two, the self-portrait on the left, a new discovery for the art world. And French great Henri Matisse painted this portrait of a seated woman. It was another that wasn't recorded in his catalogue of work. CNN's Jim Bittermann has more from Munich for you.
The art treasure trove of the century was found in a nondescript apartment building in a quiet Munich neighborhood. In the fifth-floor apartment of 80-year-old Cornelius Gerlitt, investigators found 1,400 priceless works of art, largely unknown paintings by Marc Chagall, Henri Matisse, Max Liebermann, Otto Dix, and many others, including Picasso and Lautrec. Some were centuries old, like this Canaletto from the 18th century. Many works were what the Nazis branded degenerate art and confiscated from mainly Jewish owners. Others may have been sold at a fraction of their worth by families fleeing the Nazi regime. Art historians say Gerlitt's father at one point worked for the Nazis collecting the confiscated art, and his son is thought to have taken over the collection after the father died in a car crash in the 50s. A prosecutor said it was a stunning discovery.
The flat of the accused was searched by tax and customs officials. Here, 121 framed and 1,285 unframed pictures were confiscated, some of them by Max Liebermann and others. Because of the immense idealistic value of the paintings, we have found clues that this find could be so-called degenerate art or looted art.
Authorities, assisted by art historians, have been working for more than a year trying to find the origins of the art. They say Gerlitt was being investigated because he was found carrying a large amount of cash back from Switzerland after selling this Max Beckmann painting to a Swiss art dealer.
The case is highly complicated, and all the questions of ownership are not answered.
After an investigative report by a German news magazine, prosecutors finally went public with the story. The reporter says it was impossible to talk with Gerlitt, and little is known about it.
I think he's a curious man, totally isolated.
Kind of reclusive.
Totally reclusive, living with his pictures, and perhaps these pictures are, I think these pictures, they dominated his whole life.
Cornelius Gerlitt's name is still on the buzzer here at the apartment building where he lived and kept his fabulous art collection, but he was virtually unknown to his neighbors. They've said he hasn't been seen around here for months, and he was unknown to authorities. He was on none of the tax rolls, not even the Social Security tax. No charges have been filed against Gerlitt. He is not under arrest, and the prosecutor said it's not clear which laws, if any, have been violated. But the discovery in the fifth floor apartment will almost certainly raise once again a nasty legal fight over who rightfully owns the works of art the Nazis stole. Jim Bittermann, CNN, Munich.